So we've been doing a lot of research here in the test kitchen, trying to figure out the ultimate brownie recipe. We've pretty much given up because there is no ultimate brownie recipe. And along the way, we came across the Fannie Farmer 1896 cookbook. And this is the first reference to a brownie recipe that we've been able to find. Pretty sure that there's some that are earlier. This is the one that we found. And it starts off unlike any brownie recipe we've ever made. You start out creaming together butter and icing sugar, more like a cookie. Once that's creamed together, you put in some molasses. Now she calls for Puerto Rico molasses. We've never heard of it around here at the test kitchen. Near as we can tell, it's sort of a cross between a cooking molasses and a blackstrap molasses. Really, really deep, dark flavor. The first time we made this recipe, we used a cooking molasses, and most of the people didn't really like the taste. So today we're using a fancy molasses. Kind of lightens the flavor a little bit. Once you've got the molasses all beaten in, you put in one egg. Beat that together. And then you add in the flour, and it calls for bread flour, so you want something with a little bit higher gluten content than an all-purpose flour. Pretty sure you can get away with all-purpose flour though, should be fine. Now you're probably asking yourself at this point, where's the chocolate? This is a brownie, why is there no chocolate? Apparently in 1896, there was no chocolate in the brownie. And then you're probably saying to yourself, well, if it doesn't have chocolate in it, isn't it a blonde? And for the most part, yeah, we would agree with you, but this doesn't taste like a blonde at all. There's no caramely butterscotch flavor. The molasses gives it a much deeper, darker flavor that just isn't a blonde. So the next and final ingredient are some chopped pecans. And you just sort of fold those in, and then you're gonna put it into these little tart pans. Now, in her recipe, she says, what does she say? Shallow, fancy cake tins, whatever that means. So we decided on these little tart tins, removable bottom, really easy to find. Everybody should have them. If you don't have them, you could probably bake this in a regular brownie pan. You could put it in an 8x8. Really up to you, whatever you have. As you can see, the recipe's pretty basic. I mean, there's really not a whole lot of information here. And she says next, bake in small fancy cake tins, garnishing top of each with 1/2 of a pecan. But she doesn't tell you what temperature to bake them at, or how long. And I guess in 1896, you couldn't choose your baking temperature. So we put these in an oven preheated to 350 degrees, and I mean, your baking time is gonna vary depending on what type of tin you put these in and whether your oven is actually calibrated properly. 15 to 20 minutes is a good place to start. Once they're baked, take them out of the oven, put them on a cooling tray, let them cool off, and then you can pop them out and they're ready to serve. So there you have it, the 1896 Fannie Farmer Brownie. I hope you give this recipe a try and you enjoy it. Please check us out on Twitter, Facebook, Google+, you know, all those social media places, Tumblr, Instagram. We're at LeGourmetTV in most of those places. Thanks for stopping by.